Hello, I am SquidofLove, welcome back. Combat in Star Citizen is going to be an integral part of the gameplay, and this is exactly why choosing the right combat ship, a ship that will fit your playstyle and help you achieve your goals, is going to be very important. But not all combat vessels have the same capabilities though, nor can fulfill the same role. Some are more agile than the others, some have heavier weaponry, and some are bulkier yet take a lot more beating. So today we are going to take a look at two combat vessels that are available in Star Citizen at the moment and can be included in the heavy category because of their unique playstyle. The Anvil Gladiator and the Vanguard Warden. The Gladiator is considered a carrier-based bomber, and exactly because of the heavy payload it carries, we should treat it as one of the heavy fighters, despite the fact that its length and mass are not very different from other fighters that we have already seen. The hard points of the Gladiator, though, are not very impressive. It has two size 3 hard points that can be equipped with a turret or a gun, and are currently equipped with two M4A laser cannons, size 2 laser cannons, plus one man turret that can take two size 1 weapons, and at the moment is equipped with two bulldog repeaters. The Vanguard Warden, on the other hand, is considered a long range fighter and we should treat it as a pure heavy fighter. It has an impressive weaponry but also unique playstyle, since all of its hard points are placed on the nose. The Warden comes with 4 size 2 hard points that can take a gun and are currently equipped with 4 bearing MVSA laser cannons, plus one size 5 hardpoint that can take either a turret or a gun, and is currently equipped with a size 4 Revenant ballistic cannon. It also has one man turret that can be equipped with two size 2 weapons, and is currently equipped with two Sobak ballistic repeaters. The forward mounted weaponry of the Vanguard Warden is exactly what makes this vessel a unique addition to any fleet. It is exactly what gives to this vessel a unique playstyle in the battlefield. As for their missile weaponry, this is exactly where the Gladiator shines, and this is because, of course, it is a carrier-based bomber. It has 4 Anvil double size 2 missile racks that can have up to 8 size 2 missiles and are currently carrying 8 Tempest 2, but also 2 Anvil double torpedo mount that can have up to 4 size 5 missiles and currently are carrying 4 Stalker 5 missiles. This is exactly what makes the Gladiator a fearsome opponent and a very good option against heavier, slower targets such as later capital ships, or even against structures of the enemy such as space station. The Vanguard has 2 Aegis squad platforms that can take size 1 and size 2 missiles, and are currently equipped with 8 Ignite 2 missiles. A quite decent missile weaponry that gives extra firepower to Vanguard Warden so it can destroy its opponents without any real problem. The Gladiator and the Vanguard Warden are unique combat vessels that can fill a different role in the battlefield, but that doesn't mean that they don't have some similarities. Both of these vessels have a crew of up to 2 persons, so that means that you can enhance their capabilities if you bring a friend along with you, or if you just hire an NPC when that will be possible. One of the selling points for the Gladiator is the fact that it can explore the verse with a bit of added security. So the Gladiator could be used for exploration purposes with some proper modification, and probably the same applies to the Vanguard Warden because of its multiple jump rates capabilities. So again, with some proper modifications, you might be able to take the Vanguard Warden out there and do some exploration, again with some added security thanks to its very impressive weaponry. Initially, with their default loadout, both of these vessels come with 0 cargo capacity, so they will not be the best option if you want to travel around and carry some commodities from point A to point B. But the Gladiator is giving you the option to choose to either have a bomb bay or an extra cargo hold. So that means that if you really want to choose one of these two vessels and also have the ability to carry some commodities if you need to from point A to point B, then the Gladiator might be a very good option. Let's go ahead now and take a look at their combat capabilities, how they fare in the battlefield, and of course what they can do against some enemies. Although the non-missile weapon of the Gladiator is not that impressive, it is more than enough to attack and kill most enemies, especially light fighters and in general ships combat vessels at the size of the Gladiator. And let's not forget that we can always remove the M4A laser cannons, add some size 3 weapons on the size 3 hard points, and increase our firepower, making the Gladiator a lot more effective. The true power of the Gladiator, of course, lies to its missile weaponry. With 8 size 2 missiles and 4 size 5 missiles, it can attack and destroy pretty much everything, even agile small fighters like the Vanduul Scavengers over here. Because of this missile weapon it has, and of course not the best non-missile weaponry, the Gladiator seems to be a very good option for a fleet, seems to be a very good option for a group of players that can protect it from other dedicated fighters until it can deliver its payload and of course destroy its target. That doesn't mean that the Gladiator cannot be used for surprise attacks to take down larger and heavier enemies without them noticing it. If you have the opportunity to approach an enemy, a heavier and slower vessel, with your Gladiator, then you will have absolutely no problem to destroy it or at least damage it heavily. The Gladiator of course has some disadvantages. The first one is that it relies heavily on its missiles. So if you use your missiles and you don't manage to destroy your targets, you will have to escape, you will have to flee the battlefield because your other weaponry is not that impressive, not impressive at all, and it will not be able to protect you against multiple enemies or combat ships with heavier weaponry. You will need combat escort for this purpose. The size 5 missiles are probably a great option against bigger and slower vessels, heavier vessels than the Gladiator, but apparently they cannot track very well smaller and more agile, faster combat vessels, and this is gonna create a problem if you have to rely on your size 5 missiles. Also, the existence of countermeasures against missiles make your life a lot harder against good players that know when and how to use these countermeasures properly in order to make your missiles useless. Let's also not forget the increased cost of missiles. It will cost you a lot more to replenish your missiles, to restock your missiles in the persistent universe than any other weapon. So you will have to spend a lot of money if you rely on using missiles only. The Vanguard Warden now, with its impressive forward mounted weaponry, will be able to destroy pretty much every opponent that will be unlucky enough to stand in front of it. The combined firepower of the 4 size 2 hardpoints and the 1 size 5 hardpoint on the nose of the Vanguard will make your life a lot easier if you manage to always face your opponents, something that is not always going to be easy, especially against faster and more agile opponents, and this is mainly because of the mass of the Vanguard. It is a heavy fighter after all, which will cause it to drift around a lot. Another advantage of having all of its weapons on the nose has to do with the fact that the Vanguard can take a lot of beating, can lose some of its structure, but still retain its firepower, still retain its ability to destroy its opponents and emerge victorious even with heavy damage. Also, by adding another player or an NPC on the man turret, we can protect the Vanguard for pretty much every side, and of course we can increase its firepower. The Vanguard has some disadvantages that have to do with its weaponry. At the moment, unfortunately, we cannot change the 4 size 2 weapons on the 4 hardpoints to the size 2 hardpoints in front of the Vanguard on the nose, and we don't have many options for the size 5 hardpoint. We only have some size 4 weapons that we can read with Rek and place them over there. There are some other options, but you will have to take them from other ships you own and place them on the size 5 hardpoint. Hopefully in the future we will be able to replace all of these weapons and create a more unique loadout that will fit our playstyle better. Another disadvantage is the fact that the Vanguard is a heavy vessel, so that means that it will be a bit hard to handle it at first. You will have to get used to it and you will have to practice a lot with it in order to learn how to face all your opponent and destroy them with your 5 weapons on the nose of the ship. But in general, the Vanguard Warden is an excellent heavy fighter, an excellent combat ship that can work as a Vanguard for a fleet, like its name implies, destroy multiple opponents and make it back to its fleet without any real problem. To conclude our comparison, let's take a look at the speed of these two vessels, how fast they can go. The Alvid Gladiator has a normal speed of 175 m/s, and its boost speed can go up to 265 m/s, while the Vanguard Warden, although heavier vessel, has a normal speed of 210 m/s and a boost speed at 315 m/s, which means that the Vanguard Warden might be a better option if you are looking to chase down an opponent or at least fight multiple opponents and always have the option to escape. The slow speed of the Arvid Gladiator means that it will be indeed better to use it in a fleet, in a group of players that can protect it from enemies. These were the Anvil Gladiator and the Vanguard Warden, two very different vessels with unique gameplay that can fill different roles in the battlefield, but also have some similarities. Thank you very much for joining me. If you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe for more. I am SquidofLove and I will see you next time. Bye bye.